South Dakota, your home for the next 4 years. It is a place that can launch you into a future beyond your wildest dreams. For over 125 years, students have come to this campus to discover their greatness. By choosing the U, you have chosen to join that extraordinary lineage. Our long and distinguished history will play a pivotal role in your success here and beyond. So why is USD located in Vermilion? The idea of the university was born out of a deal brokered between the river towns of Yankton, Vermilion, and Springfield. After brief fisticuffs and innocent gunplay, Yankton captured the capital, Vermilion, the university, and Springfield, the prison. For nearly two decades, Vermilion's booming riverboat economy and unruly nightlife on nearby Kidder Island delayed the construction of a university. But the flood of 1881 changed all that. When an ice dam broke that spring, millions of gallons of water roared over Vermilion in a matter of hours. The town was destroyed. Shortly thereafter, however, the town was rebuilt on the bluff overlooking the Missouri Valley, and plans to create a university began in earnest. Classes began in October 1862 and were held in the courthouse until construction on University Hall was complete. On September 18, 1883, a ceremony was held in the Baptist Church.
The opening of the University of South Dakota at this place on Tuesday evening was a most magnificent affair. Not until the wee small hours did the feast of reason and flow of soul cease and all sought needful rest. Thankful that they had been present.
The Dakota Republican. The next week, classes were held in University Hall, later to be named Old Main. Starting with only the West Wing, construction was completed on the full building in 1887. For several years, the hall served as the primary academic building as well as dining hall and dormitory for a dozen or so college students who attended USD. Then, on the night of October 14th, 1893, embers from the music room fireplace went unchecked and the University Hall caught fire. Early Sunday morning, hundreds of people from the surrounding neighborhoods rushed to help put out the flames, but inadequate water pressure allowed the fire to engulf the building.
The valuable books of the library were saved. The whole east wing seemed nearly free from fire when an explosion came, which blew out the stone gable on the south end. A student named D. Wallace from Elk Point received injuries by jumping from a window when the ceiling fell.
Dakota Republican. Within a month of the fire, over $10,000 had been raised from Vermilion businesses to rebuild Old Main. That funding, along with a tax increase levied on the entire county, restored Old Main, and students were back in the building in less than 18 months. Today, Old Main serves as the primary lecture hall on our campus, and the symbol of the university past and present.